ICE is a visual programming language that provides a lot of flexibility when it comes to generating procedural effects. In this series, we'll show how to use ICE to create and animate a particle galaxy. We'll be touching on a variety of concepts here, including ICE arrays, a bit of trigonometry, some probability, and a hint of linear algebra. For those who are familiar with programming or scripting, we'll also look at how nodes in an ICE tree relate to conventional programming elements like functions and loops. To get started, in the Model toolbar, select Primitive, Point Cloud, Empty. We'll create our particle galaxy from scratch instead of from a particle emitting object. To open the ICE tree view, press Alt-9 or press the following button on the bottom left corner. If you're in render tree mode, switch to ICE tree mode. Expand the point cloud node in the Explorer. Double-click on the particle display and set the point size to 20. This will make the particles more visible in the viewport. In the ICE tree window, select Create Ice Tree. You also have the option of creating a simulated ice tree. We'll be using that option in Part 4 to animate our particle galaxy. Let's start off by creating 5 particles in a row, just to get an idea of how to build our tree. Connect a Repeat with Counter node to the root node's first port. This is equivalent to a for loop. Any node we connect to the execute each iteration port will be executed repeatedly. If we double-click on the Repeat with Counter node, we can access its attributes. Since we're creating 5 particles, set its numIterations attribute to 5. The self.counter value attribute will store the current loop number starting at 0 and increasing up to 4. Drag an Add Point node into the tree. Connect its Add port to the Execute Each Iteration port. Drag a 3D vector node into the tree. Connect its Result port to the Positions 1 port. In the viewport, we now have 5 particles superimposed at the same position. To spread them apart, we'll need to use the self.counterValue attribute defined by the Repeat with Counter node. Drag a GetData node into the tree. Double-click on it and set its attribute to self.counterValue. Note that capitalization is ignored in ICE. Drag a Scalar to 3D Vector node into the tree. Connect the value port to the Y port. Since the value is an integer, ICE will automatically add an integer to scalar node to convert it to a decimal number. Delete the old vector and connect the output of the scalar to 3D vector node into the positions 1 port. The 5 particles are now stacked one unit apart because their Y coordinate is driven by the repeat with counter node's self.counterValue attribute. We now have an intuition of how to add points into our point cloud, however we can achieve the same effect without using the Repeat with Counter node. Instead, we'll be using an array to add all the points at the same time into the point cloud. This approach is more efficient because it takes advantage of ICE's multi-threading capabilities. Delete all the nodes except Add Point and the Root node. Connect the Add Point output to the root node's first port. Drag a Build Index Array node into the tree. Set the node's size attribute to 5. This builds an array containing integers from 0 to 4. Drag a Scalar to 3D Vector node into the tree and connect the Y port to the Index Array output. ICE will take care of automatically converting the integers to scalars. Now connect the vector output to the positions 1 port of the add point node. Note how the particles are now once again stacked in the viewport. In the tree we just built, the array of integers is converted to an array of 3D vectors and is passed to the add point node. Notice that when we were using the repeat with counter node, the positions 1 port was connected to a single vector. Now that we're working with arrays, this port is connected to an array of vectors. increase the size of the index array to stack more particles in the viewport. These particles are a humble beginning for our particle galaxy. In the next part, we'll show how to create a spiral of particles in ice.